Hey there, Panda friends, welcome to the channel again. It's me, your host, Amy from Panda Danger, and look at us, we've made it. It's almost the end of 2021, we're in December, and it's sort of a tradition right now. Let's have our top 10 video for the inks of 2021. Time flies when you're having fun, and trust me, this year that's almost behind us, I had lots of fun. And some of the inks that I've used in my previous top 10 video changed, and I'm gonna explain why is that, and I'm gonna show you what are my top 10 fountain pen inks of 2021. Remember, this kind of video is almost just like a tradition, and it is my top 10 inks. So I know this kind of videos are going to stir some controversies on why an ink is at that spot and not at a different spot in the top 10 list. And probably I'll do my best to explain why did I placed those inks at those number in the top 10 entry. So I'm very fortunate to be blessed with good health this year, and I had all sorts of achievements, personal ones and the ones that include PenVenture, and I'm really, really happy to stand in front of you guys and to showcase one more time my top 10 favorite fountain pen inks of 2021. Because I don't want to make this video too long, let's begin with them, and we are going to showcase them in pairs, because you will see why, trust me. And I'm going to try to speak a few words regarding each ink and what are my thoughts on them. So we are going to start with the number 10 on our list, and that ink and that spot is KVZ Blue Black. A very, very underrated ink that I love very much. One of the big advantages is that this big, big bottle can fit very, very large nibs, and this ink is looking very good. Let's present the other ink, Iroshizuku Yamabudo. And again, a very, very nice ink from Iroshizuku, and the bottle is very, very nice. It's glass, it has this very interesting feature right here that can allow you to go further down and draw the last droplet of ink from the bottle. Let's put the bottles right here and let me bring you my notes. So we have KVZ Blue Black number 10, Iroshizuku number 9, Yamabudo. Let's go through some of the features. So this is a swab, you can see basically the color, and it is a very, very nice blue black ink. And here, different from last year, I've tried to put up some characteristics that I think are important to me, and probably they are important to you as well, and let's go through them. So here we have the kind of ink flow, dry and wet. Blue black, it's a slightly drier ink, so that means it is not that saturated with pigment and it is slightly abundant in water. That makes it a dry ink. In my opinion, this is not super, super dry like other inks, but I would consider it a dry ink. Shading, sheen, basically that's the property of ink. Here we have shading because it's less saturated, and we can spot a very, very nice shading from this ink. Easy clean or clean nightmare. Basically, I put the scale at either ends, but of course there are some inks that are slightly easier to clean or slightly harder to clean, but I've put the scale on these two extreme ends. So this is an ink that's quite easy to clean in my opinion. Waterproof or not waterproof? This is not waterproof, it's not going to be waterproof on the paper. And last, we have a special feature, the vanilla smell. KVZ inks have a certain smell, and I do love them for that. Every time that I'm writing with a KVZ ink, I'm drooling, thinking over a vanilla dessert. So that's a special feature. Let's go through some of the details of the Iroshizuku Yamabudo, which is number 9 on our list. So we have a swab. It's a very, very beautiful purple, pinkish combination of color. I would say that is more pinkish than purple, but let's see, dry, wet. It's a quite wet ink. Trust me, Iroshizuku inks are very, very wet and very well behaving. Out of them, I think Yamabudo has the more sheen, because we go a little bit lower and we have shading sheen. So this is a sheening ink. It has a beautiful, beautiful gold sheen, and I hope the camera picks it up. Easy to clean, clean nightmare. I put a star at clean nightmare because it's slightly harder to clean, and be very careful, this ink will have some staining. So it's not recommended to be put in a demonstrator fountain pen, which is very expensive, limited edition, and you can't afford to have such a thing in it. So yeah, keep that in mind. Waterproof, not waterproof. I put a star on waterproof. I don't know if it's super, super waterproof, but I'm pretty sure it leaves some ink on the paper if you add a little bit of water. Special features, still wet and practical for a sheening ink. So yeah, sheening inks are not that practical, but this one, I would say, has the best of both worlds. So it's nice, it's practical, but also has a nice sheen if you put down a lot of ink. Remember, this paper is Tomoe River paper. So here we can see pretty much the most sheen that an ink has on this paper. Drying time is relatively quick. Sheening inks have longer periods in which they take to dry. So this one, it's drying pretty quickly. I'm gonna put my notebook right here, so don't peek. And we go to number 8 and number 7. We have Mont Blanc Corn Poppy Red. A very, very nice red ink. It's not manufactured anymore. I'm not sure if the newer Mont Blanc red ink has the same characteristics as this one, but I do have a few bottles left in my drawer just for this kind of event. And at number 7, yeah, we have Scribo Blue Cosmico. A very, very beautiful dark ink, which I grown to like lately. Big bottle, very nice, also very practical, as this Mont Blanc bottles are in the horseshoe shape. It's very, very nice. You can fill up your fountain pens very easy, and I do love these two inks a lot. Now let's bring out the notebook and let's have a look at some of the characteristics and speak about these two inks. So we have Mont Blanc Corn Poppy Red at 8. This is a swab, very, very beautiful and very, very deep red color. It's dry, wet. It is a slightly drier ink, and in my experience, brown, yellow, and reddish inks are native, a little bit dry. Shading sheen, it is a ink that's only going to shade because there isn't any sheen in it, no matter how much ink do you put down on the paper. Easy to clean, clean nightmare. So we have a star at easy to clean, so it's an ink that's quite safe and easy to clean from fountain pens. I've tried it in different fountain pens that are demonstrator, like for example my Visconti Opera Master Crimson Tide, and it cleaned out very well. And Mont Blanc inks are known to be quite safe. Waterproof, not waterproof. It is a not waterproof ink. Moving further, special feature. Cleans really nice for a red ink. Doesn't crust up. Yeah, usually red inks are going to crust a little bit if they are left in a fountain pen. With Mont Blanc Corn Poppy Red, it is not going to crust that much or that easy. So I love it a lot, and I do use it a lot. It's one of my two favorite red inks. The other one, I believe it's KVZ Grapefruit and Corn Poppy Red Mont Blanc. Moving further, Scribo Blue Cosmico number 7. A very exotic ink, in my opinion. It's very thick, very, very wet, very viscous, and it has a lot of pigment. That can be good or bad, depending on the fountain pen that you use it in. It is a wet ink, shading sheen. It's a sheening ink. It has a very beautiful reddish, almost rose gold of a sheen. It's very, very particular. I haven't met this kind of sheen color shade in any other ink. Easy clean, clean nightmare. This is an ink that's going to clean very, very hard. I've tried it in different fountain pens, and I do recommend the use for this ink in a fountain pen that's very easy to clean, like a cartridge converter or eyedropper converter fountain pen, which can be very, very easy to clean. Also, don't use this ink in a fountain pen that's very tricky to clean, like, for example, let's say a vacuum filler. Waterproof, not waterproof. So this is a little bit waterproof in my experience, and I do think it is a ink that is going to remain on the paper if there is a little bit of water involved on that paper. Special feature, super wet and saturated reddish gold sheen. That is the special feature of this ink, but you need to pay attention with it because it's going to be a little bit harder to clean. And my advice for such inks would be to not leave them for too much time in a fountain pen. If you clean such a fountain pen after 3 or 4 days with this ink inside, and you put something else or the same ink and you have this, it's going to be quite easy, if you ask me, to maintain that fountain pen in top-notch condition. Let's put the notebook away because I don't want to give away the next inks, number 6 and number 5 on our list. And let's start with number 6. And we have Graf von Faber-Castell Midnight Blue. A very interesting color and shade of blue-black. And this ink I've grown to like a lot, seeing it at the Stilografica Corsani in the shop being used by Stefano. Bought this ink from him as well, and it is a very, very nice and exquisite glass bottle with a very thick and heavy base. This won't go anywhere from your desk. At number 5, we have the one and only Diamine Desert Rose, the PenVenture exclusive ink. Very beautiful ink, diamine, and of course there will be some honorable mentions that are not going to be on the list, and probably those are mostly from diamine inks. This year I've not used them too much, and I've used the inks that are going to be featured in this top 10 list, and not that they are not good or anything, but it's just personal taste and my mood of that day, or I don't know. Let's put them right here and let's bring out the notebook and go through some of the characteristics of these two inks. Recap. Number 6, Graf von Faber-Castell Midnight Blue. A very beautiful blue-black ink. It is mostly blue than black. It's a lighter blue-black, if we can call it like this. It is a wet ink, relative wet. Although it is a shading ink, it's still wet. It's quite easy to clean and safe because I've put it inside numerous demonstrator fountain pens, and it is not waterproof. The special feature of this ink, best shading ink. Very easy to clean. Safe for most demonstrator fountain pens. Very wet for a shading ink. Now let's go through number 5, Diamine Desert Rose, the PenVenture exclusive ink. This is an ink that I like a lot because I took the liberty of choosing this ink for our store to be an exclusive ink. So this ink, you only will find it at our PenVenture website. So it is a wet ink, quite wet, heavily saturated, purple, beautiful. It is not going to shade, but it has a very nice green, gold green sheen. And I hope the camera picks this sheen up. It's very, very easy to observe. It has a lot of sheen because it is a sheening ink, clean nightmare I put here. But what I want to point out is the fact that it's slightly easier to clean than other inks, in my opinion, because I tested a lot of them before going with this shade of purple and the sheen from Diamine. Waterproof, it is waterproof. In my experience, it's not like it's going to be stick on the paper forever, but it is waterproof. Special feature, it is my sheen queen. Cleans more easy than other sheening inks, and the drying time is not that long. In my experience with sheening inks, the drying time is slightly higher. So if you are in a practical environment at the office or something like this, and you take notes and you write down with a sheening ink, you have to take into consideration that when you turn the page, that ink won't be dry. Trust me, I've tried this. Okay, let's go to number four and number three. At number four, we have an ink that was recently added to my collection of inks. So this is Tatcha Ruri, a very beautiful ink which I've got in contact with at the Dutch Pen Show, and I wanted to have it because it is a very, very beautiful, unique, vibrant shade of blue. I don't know that much about Tatcha inks, but I've liked it from the first time that I've seen a swab with this kind of blue. At number three, we have another Montblanc ink, and it is my Montblanc Irish Green. The bottle is almost done, horseshoe shape, very easy to fill with most fountain pens. And again, I have a few bottles of this ink in my drawer because I know that they are not going to produce it, or if they are producing it, I don't know if it's the same ink like Irish Green, this one, or maybe a slightly different recipe with a different shade. Let's put these two inks right here and let's go through some of my notes regarding these two inks. And we have Tatcha Ruri, and trust me, it is hurting me because I would give this ink number three, two, even also, I don't know, it's just like picking in between kids, so it's very hard for me. So we have Tatcha Ruri at number four. This is a very, very unique shade of blue, as you see in here in the swab. It is a slightly drier ink. It's also shading and sheening. So this is very, very unique for an ink in my collection, because if you put down a lot of this ink, you will see a reddish sheen. And this is immediately why did I wanted to have it, because it has both sheen and shading. It's quite easy to clean for such an ink because I do believe the balance in between the shading and sheening pigment and the sheen is very, very well adjusted, and it's perfect for ink. And also the drying time is very, very quick. Bonus points on that. It is not waterproof, and the special feature, fun and vibrant blue color, shading plus sheening. Let's go through Montblanc Irish Green at number three. Beautiful green ink, very, very nice and very unique color. I've tried dozens of green inks. They are too light or too dark. This is the perfect balance that I love in between a light lime green and a very, very deep green, like, for example, Sherwood Green. That is a little bit more black or dark. It is a wet ink. It is shading, not sheening at all. Very easy to clean, and it is not waterproof. The special feature, easy to clean, great shading, very safe for all fountain pens. In my experience with Montblanc inks, I've grown to love them because they are safe. I can safely put them in all sorts of fountain pens, and I'm referring to the Montblanc inks that I have in my collection. And I've observed that they don't stain demonstrator fountain pens. They are easy to clean. They don't do problems. I'm not going to spoil the surprise of showing you number two and number one on the top 10 list, but I'm gonna take them individually and show you. At number two, it is another Montblanc ink, and it is Montblanc Writer's Edition Leo Tolstoy Sky Blue. This is a very, very nice ink. Very different in regards of the shade of the actual blue color, and because of the fact that's no longer produced or available, I have two bottles, this one and another one that I haven't opened it, and I do love it so much that I restrain myself from using in order not to go through it very quickly. And usually I fill up the fountain pens very, very little, because I want to enjoy it and not wash it away. And the winner, number one on the list, and this may be a surprise, it is Waterman Serenity Blue, my favorite ink, and I do believe it is number one in the 2020 top 10 fountain pen inks. This is a very, very nice color of blue, very practical, inexpensive, it's quite cheap. The bottle can sit like this. You can use it very easy, and it cleans very well, and I love it. Now let me show you how they look on the paper. So this is number two, Montblanc Leo Tolstoy Sky Blue. Very, very unique shade of blue. I haven't met this kind of blue in anything. It's a dry ink. You need a fountain pen that has maybe a broad tip to get a lot of this ink. Shading, yes. Sheening, I haven't put a star, but if you lay down plenty of this ink, it has a reddish sheen, and I hope the camera picks it up. Very easy to clean, not waterproof. And the special features are great blue, very different from anything, very little sheen. If you put down a lot of ink, just like I told you, great at cleaning, save for demonstrator fountain pens, or most of the demonstrator fountain pens. And the top one, the king, call it whatever you like, Waterman Serenity Blue at number one. It is a wet ink, it is shading, but also it has sheen. If you lay down plenty of it, as you see, we have this beautiful, beautiful sheen. It is very easy to clean. It is not waterproof. And the features are right here. Easy to clean, super safe, inexpensive, great color, always my pick. If I'm having a fountain pen that I haven't used it, or it's new, or I want to try it out quickly with something, I will go with Serenity Blue, because I have big trust in it. It's not going to damage any fountain pen, even the vintage ones. The SAC fountain pens are safe from using Waterman inks, or Waterman Serenity Blue in this case, my favorite. It is quite cheap, you can find it pretty much everywhere, and it is a staple in my collection of fountain pen inks. Well, pretty much that sums up my top 10 inks of 2021. This is what I've used, this is what I've grown to like in this year, and don't judge me, those are just personal picks of mine. I hope you enjoy them, and if you have any questions or suggestions, leave them in the comment section down below. If you have also your top 10, top 5 inks, put them down, and let's see how many of these inks are on your top 5, top 10, and at what specific spot in that top 10 list. Thank you for being so supportive with the PenVenture YouTube channel. If you like my content, don't forget to give my videos a big thumbs up. This will help me a lot with the YouTube algorithm to reach out to many more just like you, which are passionate members of our fountain pen community. Down below, if you scroll, you will find the details for our website, our social media accounts, my email, and my phone number. I know that many of you that are watching are not subscribed right now. If you want to subscribe, just click here and turn the notification bell on. And if you want to see more quality content from PenVenture and myself, you have this video right here. Click and enjoy. My name is Emmy. This was my top 10 favorite fountain pen inks of 2021. Bye-bye.